Good morning, YouTube. Welcome to The Truth According to Lily. I am your host, Lily. And I was crying a little bit earlier because I tried to do a review of The Flowers of War that I watched last night, but that I stayed up until 3 o'clock in the morning to finish watching because it's like a 2-hour movie, which means I started it really late. But I kept crying and I kept going on rants about how much I hate war, and it just know that it's a very powerful movie. It's very difficult to watch. Beautifully tragic movie. If you have a strong stomach, I recommend watching it. I think if you hate war, you need to watch it. If you think war is fantastic and glorious and beautiful, you should fucking watch this movie. Because it will change your mind. It's on Netflix. It's streaming on Netflix. It has a 7.6 on IMDb. It's a foreign film with Christian Bale as the lead. It doesn't do a white hero worship trope that I thought it was going to do. In fact, this guy fails a lot. With a capital F, he fails a lot, and he knows it. But it's a very good movie, and recommend watching it. Because you're only going to probably ever watch it once. This is Ellie's, like, new favorite toy. I thought I'd just say hi and check in, and this is my wall. This is all of, like, my stuff, all of 2 accomplishments. Outstanding Community Service Award that I got when I graduated high school. Where's my Perfect Fucking Attendance Award? Okay, so I have like three, I got 2 awards when I graduated high school. Perfect attendance, because I never missed a single fucking day of high school. Outstanding community service, and then that's my diploma. And then I have all my little signs. I mean, there's some on this wall too, but on this one I have, you know, life is beautiful, have courage and be kind. Oh, and the ribbons are just little awards that I've won over the years for other stuff. There's a picture of Ellie, there's my calendar. There are my headbands, some lanyards. Those lanyards? When I moved in, Henry gave me a keep calm and carry on sign. On this wall, I have May the Force Be With You, a picture of Ellie and I the day that I got her. So I really love fake flowers. Like, when I get married, I am not having a single fucking real flower at my wedding. And I'm not throwing my bouquet. Because I don't believe in that shit. So... Actually, why don't I just tell you about what my wedding would be like? Oh my god, this is gonna be totally awesome. Okay, so I just got into a good mood. Okay, so if I ever get married, again, fake flowers all over the fucking place. I want a spring rustic kind of like wedding, you know, with like tables that are like really hardy oak or some kind of, you know, lumber. I don't fucking know. I don't know wood, okay? Leave me alone. And I want fucking twinkle lights, and I want to be outside, it's gonna be beautiful, and I'm gonna wear a cocktail dress. I don't think I wanna wear white. In fact, I'm pretty sure I wanna wear coral. I want my bridesmaids to wear whatever type of dress they want, whatever kind of style makes them feel comfortable, whether that's like a to the floor gown or a sexy cocktail dress or like whatever. Like, I want, that's the thing, I hate when brides are just like, I want to be the most beautiful person at my wedding. Like, okay, bitch, everyone is going to be looking at you no matter what the fucking bridesmaids look like. So shut the fuck up. First of all. Second of all, I want people who are going to be being... Okay, so wouldn't you want your bridesmaids to feel comfortable when they're taking those group pictures and stuff like that? And you know, I don't want my fucking bridesmaids who are my friends to fucking feel uncomfortable in something that they couldn't pick out. That's why I want them to feel just as fucking beautiful. Because we're going to be looking at these pictures for like fucking years to come, okay? And then my kids are going to be looking at the pictures. And then their kids are going to be looking at the pictures. And then blah, 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 so on and fucking so forth. I want them to look fucking beautiful. So that's why I want them to pick out whatever kind of dress style that they want to wear. Whatever makes them feel beautiful. Whatever makes them feel comfortable. It just has to be the color that I pick. It's my only stipulation. So yeah. That's my only stipulation. So yeah, blue flowers. I'm going to keep my fucking bouquet because I want to keep that shit. I don't know why people just throw it away. Wouldn't you want to keep that? Fuck tradition. Who gives a shit about that? You know, we're living in the age where we break traditions all the fucking time, okay? So, whatever. Henry is going to be my man of honor. My 2 bridesmaids that are always going to be permanent bridesmaids are my sister Hannah and my little sister Amanda. And then I have 2 other people that I would also... that I have in mind right fucking now that would be my other bridesmaids. And here is my ideal wedding morning. Okay, this is gonna sound really silly, but just bear with me. I want to wake up by myself. I want to spend the night by myself. Like, the night before my wedding, I want to spend totally by myself. I want to wake up by myself. I want to, you know, just relax. If I'm still smoking, I want to have a morning cigarette. and have croissant for breakfast. I don't want anyone to fucking talk to me. I just want to be alone. I just want to be, like, by myself, because this is going to be the last fucking night and morning that Lily is going to have to be by herself. And you know, who knows, maybe when I do find the one and I do get engaged and I do get married and all this stuff starts happening, maybe I'll feel totally differently about all of this. But as of right now, I really like sleeping by myself. I do. When I was dating my ex, I shared a bed with him for a while, and that was like, okay. But at the end of the day, just don't touch me. I don't like cuddling. I am not a big cuddler. I get hot. I get sweaty. Except for my fucking feet get fucking freezing all the time. But I'm not a big cuddler. I don't like it. I will cuddle you for like 5 minutes post-coitus, and then I'm like, get away from me. I need to go take a shower because I feel disgusting. Not because of the coitus, but because you get so gross after having sex. Like, everything's like, sometimes things are chafed. Sometimes you're like, you know, just really sweaty. Also, women should always, and men should always pee and take a shower after having sex. So, and brush your teeth depending on what kind of, you know, stuff you've been doing. Whoa, this is getting really off topic. You know more about me now. I hate cuddling, which is why I'm like a guy after sex, which is, oh yeah, this was great. Now can I go away now? Anyway, what was I talking about? Oh yeah, so this is gonna be like that. This is gonna be like my last night and morning to like just be by myself before I have to wake up every day next to another fucking person. Wow, it doesn't sound like I really want to get married that much. And the thing is, I think if I really loved someone and we didn't want to get married, like, I could just live with them. I could just live in sin with them forever. I also really like the idea of never moving in with someone. I know that sounds really weird and silly and kind of stupid, but my mom was telling me about this couple, because my mom's a stylist, and she cuts the husband's hair and she cuts the wife's hair, and they've never moved in together. Like, they both had been married, like, once before previously, and just decided when they got married that they weren't going to live together, and it works really well for them. Like, they have a really great relationship, despite the fact not living together. And when she told me that, I was like, oh my god, that sounds amazing. Because here's the thing. As of right now, I don't know when I'm ever going to be able to afford to live by myself. A year and a half, 2 years ago, I definitely could have. But due to some unfortunate circumstances, life, I don't know when I'm going to be able to afford to live on my own. So there's a very good chance that I will never live by myself because I'm getting to that age where I am thinking of settling down with someone one day. I'm 26, okay? So, I mean, say for example, I'm married before I turn 30 and I still haven't lived by myself. I'm gonna be really fucking pissed. I know this sounds really silly, but I'm gonna be kind of annoyed. I'm not gonna lie, I will be a little irritated. Oh my god, every part of my knee is just cracked. Un momento, senorita. Oh, God. That God hurts so much. I am 26, but it's like I'm 30. No, it's like I'm 66. Ellie's looking at me like, just give me another treat. Shut the fuck up, lady. Give me another treat. We're migrating. Going on in here where the light is even worse.
Okay, so this is the smoking room, which is just Henry's room. So yeah, that's my wedding idea. Should probably find a man first, though. If only you could marry yourself, like, have a ceremony for marrying yourself, like, that would be great. I would have had, like, 8 of those by now. I don't think I'm a difficult person to live with. I'm just a very quiet person. I really don't do a lot. Like, I'll clean when I have to. Like, I gotta vacuum my room in a little while, probably when I'm done filming this video. You know, I wake up really early to go to work. I come home and I lay in bed until I can fall, until it's an appropriate time for me to fall asleep. I mean, I think I'm like half introvert, half extrovert, because I'm definitely conquering my social anxieties. Like, that's gotten a lot easier for me. It's not so much that I'm afraid of going out or anything like that and going to events. I don't ever look them up to see what's going on. Although there is a craft fair coming up. Which I am thinking of going to, because I love crafts. So I don't look up events or anything like that. There's like one event a year that I go to by myself, like, that I'm fine with. I just don't want to. It's not so much that crowds make me uncomfortable or freak me out that much. Like, sometimes they do. Like, it depends on my mood. But, like, I go to a fucking Walmart and that place is always goddamn crowded. I can go to a fucking craft fair by myself. So my social anxiety has gotten better. However, it's just that I don't want to. It's not so much me being lazy. It's that I just don't... what if I run into someone I don't like that much, or just someone I don't have the energy to talk to? Like, even if I do like them, sometimes I don't have the energy to talk to you. Sometimes I just want to be there at the craft fair looking at shit and then just leaving. But no, now you're asking me, how's your life? What's going on? Oh my god, you went back to your old job. Like, tell me more about that. Like, my life is not that fascinating. I don't feel like I need to give updates on it all the fucking time, which is why I don't make, like, a lot of videos anymore, because my life is really not that interesting. Although... this time of year is very depressing for me, because this time last year, my ex and I had made it official that we were boyfriend and girlfriend, so that has been a little weird. Like, we would have been coming up on our 1 year anniversary tomorrow. And I'm not angry anymore about it. Like, I was really holding on to the anger, because I felt that if I let go of the anger, then I would just be sad all the time. And then the sadness would come back, and I would just be back into the depression that I was before. And while I'm not angry anymore, I mean, I still make fun of him sometimes, but, you know, like you do about exes, everybody does that, okay? It's nothing new. But I'm not as sad as I thought I was going to be if I let go of the anger. So I let go of the anger, and I realized that there's nothing I can really do about it. It's in the universe's hands. What happened, happened. It sucks. It doesn't make me feel good about myself, still. But I haven't let it really make me as insecure as it did. And trust me, it made me very insecure. It made me very depressed. It made me very sad. It made me very angry. It made me very melancholy. Like... one of the reasons I couldn't sleep last night and why I decided to watch a movie at 1 o'clock in the morning was because I was just thinking about my relationship and how, oh great, tomorrow or whatever would have been my 1 year anniversary. One of the things that makes it hurt so bad is because I had never felt that comfortable around a guy that I liked before. Like, I had never felt that comfortable to be myself. He made me feel like it was okay to be myself, and then on a dime... overnight, suddenly being myself was a bad thing. And that's why it hurts so much. When someone tells you that they care about you and that they like you and that they want to date you for who you are, that's an amazing feeling. That's like the Bridget Jones's thing. I like you just the way you are. You're like, fuck, great. And then literally overnight, they suddenly don't like you for the way you are and they want to change you. And the way you are isn't good enough. All of a sudden, when it was last night, and you start bargaining with yourself, well, what can I change about myself that'll make them happy? And I couldn't believe I was even doing that. I couldn't believe I was even considering bargaining what I would change about myself. Like, that's fucked up. No one should ever make you feel like that. Ever. So that's why it hurt, because suddenly how I was wasn't good enough. Literally overnight. And you know, the lying and the cheating, you know, didn't help either. That was just the fucking cherry on top of the whole fucking shit-covered sundae. I had no idea what to do. No idea. I was like, I can stick it out and hope to God he doesn't do it again. Even though he did it several times before and kept lying about it and lying about it and lying about it until, I think, in January. No, the end of December, I got an email saying, I'm so sorry. Fucking email? You sent me a fucking email. You couldn't even fucking call me or fucking text me. Like, you sent me an email. Fuck, I would have taken a Facebook message over that. And then when I tell you in my response to that email, this is the last time I ever want to talk to you, you respond to it again. And that was just our whole relationship in a nutshell. I would tell him, please don't talk to me, I need some space. And then he would blow up my phone for all day. All fucking day until I just caved. And, like, even it was... it almost made me laugh in a way when he responded, because I was just like, okay, you literally are still not respecting anything about me. I tell you that I never want to talk to you again, and then you send me this email saying, I guess I'm so sorry, and it was my fault, and I lied, and I cheated on you, and I used you, and that I told you that this girl was crazy, but oh, by the way, you know, you neglected to mention that you're fucking her. See, now I'm getting angry about it again. But I haven't really talked about it much. You know, last time I talked about it in a video, I was crying and it was pretty rough and awful. But I'm not now. Like I said, you know, it is what it is, and what it is was awful, And like I said, sometimes it still makes me feel like shit, but, you know, you have to just rise above it. You have to keep rising above it. Not that I don't ever want to send him another email saying, you know, I think you're still a piece of shit, by the way. I mean, I don't. But I really want to. I mean, I still cared about him, but I didn't love him anymore. It's like, every time I saw him, it was like, everything he said was just, and shoving the knife in just a little harder. And then a little twist. And then, oh, I'm pulling the knife out, then boom, it's gonna go right back in. Because I caught him in every single fucking lie. Every single fucking lie I caught him in. And, you know, if he is still with her, then obviously they deserve each other. Because they're both terrible people. Terrible people deserve to be with terrible people. And it's made me afraid to love again, but it's not made it impossible. It hasn't made it impossible. I still have hope. Through all of this terrible, shitty experience, ever the optimist, I still have hope. It will definitely make me recognize the signs better, and it will definitely, at least I know I have the strength and the power to leave someone who has hurt me like that. Because if it had been once, and he had admitted to it, and hadn't been caught in a fucking web of lies that even he couldn't find the way out of, it's a little different. I don't know if I would have still stayed with him, but it would have been different. When you go through the lengths of hiding, cheating from someone like that, when you take the love that someone has really given you, like wholeheartedly given you, like I really threw everything that I had into that relationship. When you take that for granted, you use it, you abuse it, you lead them on, you try and make them stay when you have some whore waiting in the wing, that's really fucked up. That's more than shitty, that's cowardice. And I doubt he's learned anything from it. Honestly, I doubt it. I would be genuinely fucking surprised. And you know what? In a few years, if I ever run into him, because it's bound to happen. I already kind of did once. I didn't say anything to him. I saw him from across the street at this event that I went to last year. We didn't talk, but we saw each other. But it's bound to happen. It's a small fucking world. You know what? And if he tells me, oh, I've changed, I've done this, I've done that, blah, blah, blah. You know, I'm gonna be like, okay, but it's gonna be really hard to actually believe him. It's really hard to believe someone who's lied to you that much. Like, even when he said he was sorry, I think he was only saying it to make himself feel better. Because it didn't make me feel any better. Oh, I hope this gives you closure. What kind of closure is that supposed to give me? Because it didn't give me anything at all. If you had admitted to what you did 6 months ago, or at this point, almost a year ago, then it would be different. All we can do, all I can do, is learn from this, grow from this, move on from this. And no, karma's a bitch and so am I. Whether it takes 20 years for karma to finally notice and get down to my file and be like, okay, she's due. We'll see. So yeah, this has just been what my wedding would be like and some life updates. How I'm doing personally and emotionally, because I want to keep you abreast to the situation. I really love using that word, abreast, in social situations because some people don't know what it means and they're just like, what about boobs? I also love using the word facetious in place of sarcastic or sardonic. I like the word archaic, like the word moniker, palindrome, enigma. Those are just some of the words that I like. Thought I'd let you know about that. Well, this has been a very long video. I hope you stuck around for it. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you got a little peek inside my soul and my emotional state and wasn't too scared or weren't too scared. Whatever. Thank you for watching. Live long and prosper. May the force be with you and stay tuned and turned on for more because there will always be more nonsense from me. It just will be sporadic and at weird times.